me any further, Lieutenant?
Oh, no. But I do have some questions for your boyfriend.
I don't have a boyfriend.
Oh my gosh. Actually, Miss Harris, I'd like to take you into my confidence regarding this investigation.
Why is that, Lieutenant?
Well, because if I don't, there's really no reason for us to keep talking.
Well, then take me into your confidence with confidence, Lieutenant.
Something's very wrong here. I just met an opening night cast, who all seemed incredibly eager to close.
Well, I can understand how they might feel. They all gave up wonderful jobs and hit Broadway shows to work up here in Boston. I've never performed a day outside of the city, and Bambi's had to fight for under at every step of the way just to be in the chorus, but the rest of the cast are underpaid and overworked. Though surely not enough to drive any of them to murder.
Keep in mind, I'm within arm's reach at any hour of the day or night.
You think I'm in some danger?
No, that was a completely unrelated thought.
You live in danger on a daily basis, don't you, Lieutenant?
No. Most of the time, it's just paperwork and procedure. Detectives have no opening night, Miss Harris. We make our entrance after the curtain has fallen on someone else's life.
But it's a calling, like being a doctor or a teacher.
Or an actor.
Well, I suppose you're right. I can't imagine doing anything else with my life. It's not a bad thing to be married to one's work, is it?
Oh, no. No, not at all. But sometimes it's no honeymoon. I love my job. I really do. And if I say so myself, I'm good at it too. I catch the bad guys, well, most of the time. So it's a good life. A perfectly good life. Not exactly sublime. Finish my work, and I crawl into bed. I reflect as I turn out the lights, and the day that's to come, and the week that's ahead, will be lunch out of morning, and coffee shop nights. Lunch out of mornings, and coffee shop nights.
But it's reassuring to have such a dependable schedule. Matinees every Wednesday.
Or brisket and broad beans each Thursday.
With your friends.
Yeah, I like my pals. The guys on the force. We're not very social. They're all married, of course. Sometimes we go bowling or grab a few beers. So it's a fine life. A perfectly fine life. I'd give it sometimes I think, at the end of the day, when I've read the last burglar is right, that the life that I lead is a thing that goes right. With its lunch cover mornings and coffee shop nights, lunch cover mornings and coffee shop nights.
But you're acting wrong. Don't they make for a change?
Oh, Miss Harris. Each year, from May 23rd to the 12th of June, when I turn my life over to the Swallow Street Players, that's more than a vacation for me. That's an overture of hope. The curtain rising on the greatest joy of my life. The rest of the year, the life that I lead, it's a little bit gray. There are plenty of
I'd be delighted, but you won't let us leave.